anybody tell me where the Blarney roses grow? Can anybody tell me where the Blarney roses grow? Hey!
Welcome back to the GAA Handball Show, as we now showcase an effervescent Kilkenny maestro whose domination in the over-40s codes saw him collect the Masters All-Star Award on this special night.
The 2011 Masters All-Star Player of the Year Award will see another legend of the game honoured tonight, as this goes to Kilkenny's Duxie Walsh.
Duxie hits it down the left. Duxie's gonna let Tom come over to deal with that one there. Keenan's gone onto the back wall, very dangerous on the back wall.
Tom's not really going for the kill, so he can't afford to miss any. It's a good ball.
Back up, right. Duxie has the right corner now if he wants to.
Oh, class yeah, shot from Duxie Walsh.
In the international arena, Ireland continue to lead the way with a wealth of titles in the USA, Canada and Europe. And Fiona Shannon's US Open double saw her pick up the coveted International Player of the Year award for GAA Handball.
Player of the Year for 2011, and that is Fiona Shannon from Antrim.
Another aspect of the sport which is highlighted on the night is the many special achievements which are witnessed, and in Andrew Dowling, the Monavay club certainly have an individual to be hugely proud of.
2011 Special Achievement Award goes to Andrew Dowling of Leash.
It was mainly through my father. See, my father was involved in this club from the time it was set up, so it was kind of like I used to always be going around with him to games, watching different lads playing all the time, and it just kind of took from there. I played football and I played soccer and everything, but I prefer playing the handball any day. If you give me a hard game of handball, I prefer that to playing football or soccer any day. I absolutely love playing the handball as opposed to even any other sports. But for me, I think it's the best game in the world. These are the dreams
of the sleeping father. I just brought him down when he was 7-8 years of age. I used to bring him to the court when we'd be coaching juveniles. At first he was very shy and didn't want to go in, but eventually he went in, and again the lads, Tom Brennan, all those lads were coaching juveniles here, and he started to play, and I think Billy Love was the man that really got him with that special shot on his, from the left, using his left hand on his right, that special shot. Billy coached him that for a while, but he perfected it.
Competing is for me the main thing. You have to win there and play against all these lads, win and play against them, regardless of whether you have one arm or whether you have one leg or whatever. I think just getting in there and playing is the main thing. Whether it be football, soccer, hurling, whatever, I think it's the main thing. When lads get in and just play it again.
All ranks of the sport are highlighted and revered at the National Awards, and these also included the President's Award for Services to GAA Handball, going to Dublin's Sean Clerken, who sadly passed away in 2011. Roscommon's Angus Cunningham, who collected the Coach of the Year Award. The Official of the Year Award went to Clare's Tommy Hegarty. And the Club Person of the Year Award, which saw Bracky clubman Sean Clark from Tyrone honoured. The top awards on the night see the Female Player, Male Player and Club of the Year take centre stage. Want you to make me feel like I'm the only girl in the world. Like I'm the only one that you'll ever find. Ladies handball in Ireland is undoubtedly at an all-time high right now. Kerry's Maria Daly topped the All-Star cast though, in light of her historic All-Ireland title wins in both courts. And what a year it was for the men's game. Just shoot for the stars. If it feels right, then aim for my heart. If you feel like it, take me away. And Cavan's Paul Brady broke another record in the 40 by 20, but 2011 was all about Westmead's Robbie McCarthy, who tasted All-Ireland Senior and US Open glory for the first time.
To the very, very last award of the night, and this is a special one because it involves hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of different people. It's the Club of the Year Award, and with the increase in the number of clubs, handball clubs in the country over the last few years, it's particularly special to be able to celebrate another club here tonight. We could, of course, only have four nominees in this category.
Of course, the club is so special within all the GAA family.
It's very easy to put four players into a court and watch them. But how did they get there? I mean, they'll all go home and say they were well treated, they were well taken care of, Ellie was in a great condition, all down to the people in the background.
We have a fair standard here. We have a lot of youngsters. We have maybe 8-9 people looking after youngsters here. So we have the bones of 60 or 70 youngsters playing here all the time. All year round, we don't stop. We go 60, 30, 40, 20. So we try to keep going.
Yeah, we're very proud of this. This is probably one of the best handball alleys in Ireland. Everything in it you see is top of the range. There'd be no expense spared to put this together.
And for Roscommon's Mount Talbot, there is no better example of accelerated growth. We now travel to see how one of the newest clubs in the country could have achieved such status in such a short period.
The community spirit here is second to none. Each of the families have done Trojan work the last week or so in preparing the village, in preparing the area, in preparing the food for competitors for the weekend. Everyone has taken on board a task, and they have acted, the performance to date has been second to none, really, and it's a credit to them, and without that you have nothing, and in Yarka Carla Gaila, The development of the club, and also the development and the running of this competition, where 175 players are playing this weekend, will spread the game, and not just in our own club and expand our own club players. It'll also lead to the development of new clubs. Handball in this area wasn't being played formally. That was one thing we always set out, and one of the aims and objectives is to get people playing handball. It doesn't matter where you're from, it's not confined to a parish boundary or to a local boundary.
This year's Club of the Year, it's rapidly growing, and it's the Mount Talbot Club in County Roscommon.
It's great being here tonight because everybody really loves handball and is trying to promote the game and do the best they can for the game. So it's great to see all the support.
It's gone from strength to strength over the last, I would say, 3 to 4 years.
Capham Grumodisor Grumamlian and on Krivna Herons Karakafa Fika, Augusta Sula Mashlini and the Reached.
It's going to be a fantastic year next year, and everybody's going to be training and getting ready. And I think it's going to be a phenomenal success, and Hamilton's going to take off big time next year in 2012.
It's obviously a great honour to be able to represent your country in anything, and then to go out and win. You know, there's great, atmosphere between all the players over at Christmas time especially, so it's really enjoyable.
Handball 2012, watch out for it. It's going to be a big year.
This opening episode in the GAA Handball Show series has highlighted some of the stars of the sport in the past season. And in episode 2 after the break, we travel west to Castlebar to see how the game has exploded internationally, with one wall handball now sweeping the globe. Jumping all around.